AI on the edge is very important these days, but one of the key factors is the amount of power that's required. We'd like to have a lot of intelligence, but it doesn't necessarily come cheap. So, Scott, could you tell us a little bit about the spot technology that Ambiq has developed?
Yeah, so we developed our core spot technology to address exactly this problem, right? We want to put maximum intelligence into a tiny little power budget. And the way we do that is something we call subthreshold power optimized technology. And it's based on an old approach to low power, which involves running at extremely low voltages. In fact, those voltages are so low that you may not turn a transistor fully on. Now, the benefit of running at such low voltages is energy is proportional to the square of voltage. So we get quadratic energy reductions as voltage drops. That requires a whole bunch of techniques to be deployed to make circuits robust under such conditions. But we've been able to do that. And in fact, by applying spot to conventional MCU cores like ARM's Cortex-M55 or ARM's Cortex-M4, we can offer a very familiar software development environment at a fraction of the power budget that our customers are used to.
Now, in terms of the design of the chip itself, how do you utilize spot within the various peripherals, processors? Is it the same architecture all the way through?
Yeah, so we use a mixture of approaches. So for most of our digital circuits, we'll apply what is called near threshold operation. And that is where we're running at just above the turn on voltage, the threshold voltage of the transistor. And that offers a really good balance between power and performance. In the analog domain, we'll run often at the deep subthreshold mode. That offers extreme low power, especially when you're talking about sleep modes. And then for certain circuits, we'll even run at standard operating voltages. GPIOs, for example, I want my customers to have an experience when they use our chip that matches what they get from other chips, which means that the pad ring surrounding the chip needs to run at standard voltages. Certain memories need to run at standard voltages. So we have a mix of sub-threshold, near-threshold, and standard operating voltages inside our chip, and it takes a lot of technology to make all of that possible.
Now, your latest chip, the Apollo 5, is based on the ARM Cortex-M55 that you mentioned. One of the features of that are some enhanced instruction sets features for artificial intelligence. Could you tell us a little bit about the support that you have and some of the development tools that you have to complement this?
Well, so first of all, the M55 is an amazing compute engine. It is capable of doing signal processing with great efficiency. So if you think about building a typical neural network, you've got to do pre-processing before you bring the data in. So you might be running FFTs and building a spectrogram. It's really good at those. It's got a big wide vector unit and is well tuned for that. For the neural network itself, similarly, it has a big vector unit and can run those efficiently. But none of that is any good if you don't have a whole software suite paired with it. And so what we offer to our customers is a suite of software that we call Neural Spot. And the way to think about Neural Spot is it's that layer of software that sits between TensorFlow, which is the Google's training framework, and the bare silicon itself. It provides a bunch of utilities that makes neural network development easy. And we couple that with software that we call our AI development kits, our ADKs. And these are neural networks that we developed and trained in-house, and then we provide them to our customers in reference form. So they include the network design itself, everything you need to train that, including the training data, including weights, and then we hand that off to the customer. And the goal is not to give them a perfectly sealed and ready to go production worthy neural network. It's to give them a seed to start their own effort. So if there's one message I have for developers out there, it's that AI development is very attainable today, right? We're providing the tools that make it relatively straightforward. What I'll also say is you have to be careful with it. There's a lot of talk about wonderful NPUs and great hardware out there to accelerate neural network development. But in reality, a lot of the inefficiencies lie at the software level today. And so we provide tools that allow you to benchmark where you're at. The M55 has some amazing profiling capabilities that allow you to get a sense of what's really going on inside there. So don't be afraid of neural network development on Apollo 5. And if you do it, make sure that you're paying close attention to what that profiling data looks like.
Well, briefly, there are a lot of other features that the Apollo 510 has. For example, it has non-volatile MRAM. Could you tell us a couple of the other features, maybe the GPU and the security aspect?
Yeah. So a lot of our customers have big, rich displays. And so we have included a GPU, a 2.5D GPU on board. That GPU runs up to 250 megahertz and is achieves performance that's nearly four times better than the previous generation of Apollo, which was already a really nice chip for graphics development. And that's coupled with some really big memories that allow you to store big frame buffers, big graphics assets, or back to our previous discussion, have big neural networks in locally. And that's all on-chip memory. It's not in-package memory. It's all on-chip memory that's hyper-efficient. And then on the security front, look, security is a really important part of the neural network story. If we're going to entrust our data to these devices and let them learn from us, we have to make sure that all of our data is secure. And so Apollo 5 was designed from the ground up with security in mind. So we have, of course, cryptographic acceleration, but we have a complete secure lifecycle management protocol built into the chip. And we also have support for Trust Zone built into the chip. So really secure chip, extremely low power, and very performant.
Great. Well, thanks for filling us in on Spot and the Apollo 5 family.